So, dears, this is how to cross the Atlantic with a small airplane. Well, first, we start in Canada. This is Goose Bay, Charlie Yankee Yankee Romeo. It's a good airport, good runways, weather is okay. However, two things about this airport. First tip. When you park for overnight in Goose Bay, you should use a hangar. It's cost like a few hundred of bucks, but it's worth it. I did a delivery with a small jet, and we put the aircraft in the hangar. Came back in the morning. It was very good. Aircraft was ready. If you put it overnight without a hangar, you might find issues with batteries or avionics, and so. So I suggest you will pay for the hangar and it will save you a lot of problems. Second thing, here in the FBO, you can find a small room with a phone. You can call directly to Narsarsuaq, Bravo Golf, Bravo Whiskey in Greenland. You can talk directly to the tower. Good questions to ask them is first, how is the weather currently, right now? How's the runway condition? There is a single runway over there. Is there is any traffic landed? Any traffic planned to land there on your estimate time of arrival? This is a good information you want to know. Fuel is available. You want to know that definitely. You do this ferry with actually three legs. Each leg is approximately 700 miles. So with a small aircraft, I guess you will not have much more than this. So you really want to do it right. Okay, so first leg, you go from Goose Bay to Narsarsuaq. Narsarsuaq is a small airport next to the fjord in Greenland. It has an ADF approach and I intercept straight in approach. There was some weather, there was some snow. However, after I broke out from the clouds, there was a nice lake, as you can see before the runway, and I just landed nice and easy. I went to the tower, paid the fee, gathered fuel, waited like 45 minutes there, and then departed towards the next destination in Iceland. In Iceland, you have two good airports to go. It's Keflavik or Reykjavik. Keflavik is a bigger airport with a big runway, ILS. I had weather issues, so I prefer to land in Keflavik. It was a good decision. There is a big long runways over there, and I landed on the ILS, and it was okay. Reykjavik is also an option for a small aircraft. It's a small runways, it's a small airport, it's also an options. Anyways, one can use as an alternate to the other, so it's a good place. Another thing, when you depart from Narsarsuaq, they might give you a right turn out on the SID. You can ask for Victor Mike Charlie, VMC departure, and turn left directly to your en route waypoint. Last leg is, of course, from Iceland to Europe. You can use Shannon Echo India November. November, it's a great airport in Ireland. I did it to directly to Stansted Echo Golf, Sierra, which was also okay. Again, it's another approximately 700 mile, and actually, in this route, you don't have to have an HF. You can do it on a route outside of HF. You can use only VHF, and well, it's approximately around 2,000 mile, And I did it on a one day with a very light jet in a Embraer Phenom 100. It was great. It was okay. Don't forget to take the raft and some survival kits just in case, and have a good trip. See you.